Okay, now I want to cover down below these tabs down here. And while these really don't change with the tabs up here, they do give a bit of unique information for whatever you're actually looking at. For example, I'm going to be looking at this address, the homepage for Your Made in Italy. It has all the URL info right here. Again, the H1, H2, it's basically all of this across just in a single column like this. And then what you can also look at it from here as well is the inlinks, which is where other internal web pages are linking back to the homepage. Outlinks, where things within the homepage are linking to something else on that page. And usually it's, as you can see here, a bit of static CDN images, content delivery networks images, and just basically the main menu is what it looks like. You can have any image info that's on there as well. Again, same thing. But the main idea is how I talked about Yoast. This is pretty cool, and for Screaming Frog SEO Spider specifically, that's why I want to cover also free tools like Yoast. But when you have Screaming Frog SEO, you actually get your snippet previewer or SERP snippet, which is search engine ranking position snippet, and it just shows you what this will look like. So you can come in here and just obviously be able to see, hey, this is going to show up a little bit short. Maybe we can add some more there. Something like, let me see if there's, there we go. This is one that got truncated, so it's a little too long. So we obviously know we need to work on that and shorten up this one specifically. So we can obviously see right here, yep, it gets truncated. That also gets truncated. The description could probably use a bit more. And again, it shows you what's remaining specifically. So that's the nice thing about having the version of Screaming Frog SEO Spider over all of the other free ones that are out there, is that it shows you these types of information, you know, how many pixels you have remaining, etc. And then finally, you can see the rendered page. Right now, I don't have it available. I'd have to simply export it or start it up. But with that being said, again, everything inside of this little bottom area is just showing all of this data right here, just in a single column like this. And it's, if you end up going to About Us, again, all of this is going to change. So it's only viewing one at a time when you see it down there. And then from there, obviously everything else will change around. You can see how it's moving. So that's basically it for all of the lower tabs. The biggest thing that you can get out of this, again, is the SERP snippet, so you can individually check each specific page and see, hey, is something getting truncated? Is something a little short? Maybe we could make it even larger. Same thing for there as well. So that's what all of that is for down there.